All right, everybody, we are back now. We had to interrupt the show. I had to do three stand-up comedy spots, two at the Improv and one at the Comedy Store, and then we had to go to Mel's Drive-In and get two wellness shots and a waffle sundae. I had a little bit of my cayenne pepper and ginger wellness shot. It was not good, so I opted to not be well. Ben took his down. He likes spice. He's a Texas boy. I don't know what the fuck that was, but it was not for me, that wellness shot. I was very angry earlier about the Oscars, and I'm right about everything I'm saying, but, you know, we're calmer now. We've all had our food. Everybody is. We understand that, you know, people deal with all kinds of things. There are people that are not trusting the process with my new business venture, which kind of is upsetting me. Many people know that I'm a comedian. We've kind of established that already. But what people don't know is that's not my real passion. My real passion has always been jewelry. And I've seen the look on someone's face when you give them something that is special and unique. And to me, what that is a perfectly set stone. Perfectly set stone. It could be topaz, could be one of the other ones. And jewelry has been my passion. Now, a lot of people are like, they're not, we have a mail order jewelry business called Jewels by podcaster Tim Dillon. A lot of people have given us a lot of money and are now getting angry at us because the jewels haven't showed up at their home for them to sell. Now, this is the type of amateur bullshit that I expect from some of these people. This is amateur hour, okay? Number one, you don't need the physical jewels to sell. You can get out there and you're selling a lifestyle. You're selling an idea. You're selling an identity. So you're going to get the jewels. They're coming. But I fear for many of you because the complaints are so unnecessary. And I just feel like a lot of you aren't taking it seriously. You have one job when you sell jewels by podcaster Tim Dillon. You have to convince people that they are not happy because they don't have the right jewelry. And you also have to convince them that they need to sell jewelry for me and you and this whole I'm trying to start a company here. And a lot of people don't take me seriously. I'm trying to start a goddamn company, an operation. And I just feel like a lot of you are ungrateful because many of you have no idea how to be an entrepreneur. And I am a businessman. That's what I've been since I'm a little baby boy. I've been a business boy forever in my whole life. All of my existence has been business. Crunching numbers, chopping the onions, making it work, fitting a square peg into a round whatever. The point is, I don't need your fucking ungrateful mouth. Oh, the kid isn't here. The jewel kit's not here. Improvise, you stupid bitch. Figure it out. It's going to get there. It's on its fucking way. You're going to get it. Also, we're coming up with the sales strategy because I realize that many of you need much more help than I had anticipated, which is okay. I want to give you that help. But many of you are not salespeople. You're not closers. I can hear it in your voices. I can hear it in your emails that are very that are rage-filled. When you send me an email and you're like, I spent all this money, I haven't been given any guidance or any help, I don't even have the jewels, where are the jewels? I'm telling everyone I'm selling jewelry for you and I can't even do it. You know, all I hear is failure. And I don't know, is that who you are? Is that who you want to be? That's not who I want to be. That's not what I am. So we're doing a seminar in Arizona, Hilton or Marriott, we're going to see. And it's going to be 3 days. It's going to be a 3-day intensive sales training seminar. We're going to train you on the product. You got to get trained on the product. Then you got to get trained on the strategy. And then once you have the product and the strategy, you're good to fucking go. Okay? Product plus the strategy, sales strategy. Okay? Now I'm going to show you. This is an example. And again, you're not going to be at the level I'm at for a very long time, maybe never. But if you listen to me, I've invited Ben to lunch. Ben is someone I have not seen in a very long time. I've invited him to lunch by messaging him on Facebook. We do a lot of our ads on Facebook. Mm-hmm. Stay away from Twitter. Stay away from Instagram. Stay away from, God forbid, TikTok. Stay on Facebook. What I like about Facebook is that Zuckerberg, they're not trying to verify everything on there. They're just letting it fly, which I think is very important for a small business that's just starting. So I message Ben and I want to get lunch with him. Now, I don't bring up Jules by podcaster Tim Dillon in the message. I just reconnect with him authentically. And he agrees to have lunch with me at the local diner. Now we've done some of our bullshitting, and now it's the time when I'm going to pounce. The word is pounce, like a puma would, like a big cat. Have you ever seen a big cat fuck something up with his paw? Mm-hmm. That's what we're doing, but we're helping people. Do you understand that? I'm helping him, but because he is so lost, I need to paw him like a large cat would, mm-hmm, to help him. Now, so this is the time when I'm going to do it. Huh. This lunch has been very good. I've enjoyed it.
It was great.
Yeah, it's very
so good.
It's very good. I enjoyed. I like rye bread.
Me too. It's wonderful. It's so nice to see you. I haven't seen you since high school.
How's things?
It's pretty good. You know, things could be better though. Not gonna lie.
Well, let me tell you a story. Do you want to hear a story? You have time for a story?
I'd love to hear one. I have nothing to do.
When I was a young child, I became obsessed with jewelry. Mm. I would steal it, I would wear it, and I would sell it. Mm-hmm. And even though looking back on that now, that seems immoral, mm-hmm, what it did was give me a real understanding of the market for jewels. I have an opportunity for you. I have a company right now that I haven't told anybody about, because I'm still trying to decide who's worthy about knowing about it. It's called Jewels by Podcaster Tim Dillon. Now, I see your face and you're surprised and you're shocked. And I think maybe you feel a little lucky. You seem to feel a little lucky. You're not wrong to be lucky. What I want you to do is I want you to go into your community. I want you to go to your family, your friends, people who trust you, people who you've built rapport with over your entire life, and sell them jewelry that I have provided for you to sell them. I get my jewelry from the best jeweler. Mm. I won't tell you where.
Okay.
But have you seen the movie Uncut Gems?
Yeah.
Him. There's nothing like the look on someone's face when you marry them to a perfectly set stone. Many people aren't happy in their life. They're fat and they're on heroin. And the reason that this is the case is because God is dead and the country is shit now. Even though it's kind of good, it's still shit. But one thing that always glitters brightly is a jewel. And everybody wants it. That's why, do you remember Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs?
Yeah.
What were the dwarfs doing?
They were mining for little jewels.
That is the oldest story in America, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Really?
Yes. So in the beginning, there were jewels. There will always be jewels. And when you have to make people understand how lucky they are to be in the unique position of being sold jewelry over the phone or in person at their house. Because you say, you could take a trip, Mrs. Miller. When I go into a sale, I go, hello, Mrs. Miller. You could go anywhere and buy jewelry, but you're not buying it from a trusted name and you're not buying it from somebody that has a passion. So what are you really doing? You're being stupid. And if you're stupid, you're going to fail. But I don't fail, I win. Because I'm not stupid, I'm smart. My jewels are bright. They shine. Remember the rap song, Shine Like the Diamond.
Shine Bright Like a Diamond.
Shine Bright Like a Diamond. That's not the way it goes, but I like the way I'm doing it a little better. Shine Bright Like a Diamond. The best thing about these jewels is I'm not only selling them to you, I'm selling them to you so that you can sell them to other people.
Mm, so you're trying to help me.
I want to help you. I want to help you create a revenue stream. I don't want you to have to get up and work a 9-to-5 job like some dumb pig. I want you to be able to create your own business and your own opportunities. I want you to have multiple revenue streams. I want you to have a sales strategy that works for you. I want you to put your tentacles into the community and choke people very softly so that they understand that Jewels by Podcaster Tim Dillon is the fucking thing that is going to be the thing that's going to happen. Mm.